feel free to be on camera or not. It's up to you. This is more about being relaxing and just decompressing and working on mobility. So the first thing we're gonna do is work on some breathing. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put my feet up on this box. I'm gonna put a hand on my belly and a hand on my chest. And I'm gonna breathe in for four, hold for four, and breathe out for four. Let's get started. Breathing really is a foundation of mobility. So we're gonna set that up first and foremost. So go ahead and breathe in four counts. Hold for four. And breathe out. Four, three, two, one. Again, breathe in. Four, three, two, one. Hold. You want to make sure your hand on your belly is moving and not so much the hand on your chest. And breathe out. Four, three, two, one. You can breathe out through your nose, breathe out through your mouth, whatever feels good. Take a deep breath in. Four, three, two, one. Hold it for four. Feel the expansion through the belly. And breathe out for four. Three, two, one. We're gonna do a couple more. Breathing in through the belly. Four, three, two, one. Hold it. And breathe out. Four, three, two, one. Let's do one more. Set up a good foundation. Breathe in. Four, three, two, one. Hold for four, three, two, one, and let out. Four, three, two, one. Awesome. Okay, from here, I'm just gonna give myself a little pillow. And I'm gonna grab a foam roller. You do not have to have this, but it gives me a little bit of help. So I'm gonna lie on my side, and I'm gonna put that knee up on the foam roller, make sure it's hiked up into my chest. Now one option here is to keep this bottom leg straight and keep it there and grab your ribs and open up towards the ceiling. Option two, if you can, it would be to reach down and grab this foot and open up towards the chest. I see someone else in the waiting room. We're just gonna let in. Cool. Hey, Betsy.
Hey, can Betsy. Can you show that again? Like, I'm having trouble figuring out what the mechanics.
I sure will. Hey, Betsy, good to see you. I'm just gonna show that one again. We're just setting up into our mobility.
Here I am, okay.
Yay.
Yes, I'm slowly getting this back into my schedule. So.
Good, I'm glad. All right. All right, I'm just gonna mute everyone and we're gonna set up for that pretzel again. So we just got started with some breathing and now we're going into our first position here. I'm gonna lie on my side. I'm gonna take my top leg across my body. And so you can have that bottom leg straight or reach down, grab that foot, and you're gonna open up towards the ceiling. So if that's a little bit too much for you right now, you're just gonna keep that leg straight, grab your ribs, exhale and open up. This version here where I grab my foot is called the pretzel. I'm sure you can see why. It was named after Brett Jones and a pretzel. So this opens up all the front of your body, your hips, your mid back, your job here is not to fight anything, but to just breathe, release the tension, and see if you can open up all of your chest towards the ceiling. We're just gonna hold this for a little bit. And like I said, if that's too much, just do this version. Bottom leg straight, open up towards the ceiling. They're both great. Deep breath in, let go of all the tension, all the care. Exhale out. I'm just gonna grab my foot again. I'm gonna go for a few more breaths. Breathing in and breathing out. All right, I'm gonna turn over to my other side. I'm gonna show you my back because that might actually help you to see another angle. So I'm gonna bring that top knee up onto my block. I'm gonna grab this foot and open up towards the ceiling. And like I said, feel free to keep this leg straight if you can't grab it. So I just roll, grab, and you're gonna try to open up towards the ceiling. Breathe in, breathe out, letting go of the tension. I see Pepper's happy tail in there, that's cool. Couple more breaths here. Just enjoy that feeling of being in a pretzel. What a mobility pretzel. And relax. Okay, from here, we're gonna do a couple different plank sequences. So option, if you have trouble, would be to elevate your hands onto something. So the first round, I'm gonna show you with my hands elevated, but you can also have them on the floor. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to come into a plank. I'm going to downward dog, and while I'm here, I'm gonna pedal my feet. Then I'm gonna step forward. Option here is to keep the back knee down. If you can, you can keep it up. I'm gonna windmill that arm around, and then I'm gonna sit back and do a hamstring stretch. All right, so that's the sequence. We're gonna do all five on the right side before we switch. So I'm gonna come back to plank, go into downward dog, pedal those feet in place, great ankle and calf stretch, right foot, big step forward. Option, set the back knee down. We're gonna windmill around and then sit back to hamstring. Yep. Coming back into plank, downward dog, foot pedal, still right leg we're gonna work with here. Right leg, big step forward, windmill, and sit back. Yeah, good. All right, go back again, downward dog. Pedal those feet. Right foot. Big step forward. Windmill. And hamstring. Let's do two more on this side just for kicks. Downward dog. Pedal. Right foot. Big step forward. Windmill. And hamstring. All right, one more on this side. We're gonna go downward dog, pedal, right foot, big step, windmill, and hamstring. Awesome. All right, I'm just gonna get rid of these. We're gonna do left leg now. set up that plank. Downward dog. Pedal. Left foot now. Big step forward. Windmill around the other side. And hamstring. Good. Step it back. Downward dog. Pedal. Left foot. Big step. Windmill. And hamstring. Good. We go again. Sorry to be obnoxious saying this every time. Downward dog. Pedal. Left foot step. Windmill. Hamstring. Great. We're going to do two more here. Downward dog. Pedal those feet. Yeah, good. Left foot steps forward. Windmill. Hamstring. And we go one more. Downward dog. Pedal. Left foot, big step. Windmill. And hamstring. Good. Give your hands and your wrists a little break. We're going to do one more plank sequence that involves downward dog. All right, so I'm gonna go back to my right leg again here, this good old guy. I'm gonna reset up in my plank. Here's what we're gonna do this time. We're gonna downward dog. We're gonna lift one leg up, bend, and then swoop it through to a pigeon. Then I'm gonna take a breath here. So that's this sequence. All right side first. Let's try it out, shall we? We're gonna go downward dog. Right leg lifts. We're gonna bend and then swoop it forward to the pigeon pose. You can stay up or you can come down. Just hold that for a breath. And we go again. We're gonna downward dog. Right leg again, lift up, bend, and swoop forward, right into pigeon. We're gonna get that for a breath. Good, yep. Let's do three more on this right leg. Downward dog, lift, bend, and bring forward. We gotta enjoy that pigeon pose for at least a breath, right? Good. Going back again. Downward dog. Lift, right leg, bend, swoop it forward. Take a breath. One more on this right leg. Downward dog it. Lift, bend, swoop. Good. Yes, yes, you're doing great. Good, good. All right, now we're gonna do that same thing with the left leg lifting. So we're gonna downward dog it. Lift that left leg up, bend, and then bring it forward into pigeon. Take a breath here. We're gonna hit those hips from every angle. Let's do it again. Downward dog, left leg lifts, bends, and swoops forward into a pigeon. Pigeon pose. All right, we're gonna do three more on the left here. Downward dog, left leg lifts and bends and comes forward. Yep, yep, yep. Going again, two more now. Downward dog, lift, bend, and pigeon. Starting to creep forward a little bit here. And one more now. Downward dog. Left leg lifts, curls, and comes forward. Last time, enjoy that pigeon. Cool. Doing good on time. Now shake out of that. We're gonna move on to a different body position. Yay! So the hip is a, you know, ball and socket joint, so it extends and flexes, it abducts and adducts, and it rotates. So we're gonna be working our way into that, but first, we're gonna set up in a quadruped position. I'm gonna take one leg straight out to the side. So my foot is lined up with my knee. Straight out to the side there. And I'm gonna walk my hands forward a little bit. I'm gonna show to the side now. So I'm gonna rock forward, and then I'm gonna sit back. Now we wanna make sure we're not a sad dog, but that we lead with the pointy end of the tailbone. Straight back. We're gonna rock forward, extending the hips, and rock back. So we get a nice inner thigh stretch. Ooh, it feels so good. Rock forward. Rock back. Remember to lead with the tailbone, lead with the butt. Making sure we avoid that sad dog. Keep the curve in your spine, the natural curve. We're gonna do a couple more here. Forward and back. Good. Forward, back, forward, and back. So I'm gonna do now is just switch sides. So I'm gonna take that other leg straight out to the side, lined up with my knee. I'm gonna do the same thing here. Forward, sitting back, lead with the butt, forward, and back. Good. And the key with all these, don't sweat about whether you can do it perfectly or not. Just focus on keeping your breathing going. That's really the most important thing, is to let go of the tension. We want to have tension when we want to have tension, not when we don't want to have tension. We're going to do a couple more of these. These are stretches I do quite a bit on a daily, you know, warm-up mobility drill basis. And relax. Okay. Here we're getting into the ball and socket rotation point. I'm gonna set up in a shin box. Not to be confused with 90-90, we're a little bit different. So I got my foot against my opposite thigh. If you have a hard time getting in this position, no problem. You're just gonna lean back, take some pressure off. So from here, I'm actually gonna pick both my feet up off the ground and switch to the other side. I'm just gonna hold that. Go ahead and follow along with me. We're just gonna do a couple of those switches. If you need to lean back to switch, that's okay. Gonna pick those feet up and reset. So my hip, this hip is externally rotated, this hip is internally rotated. Going again, other side. Good. Just holding it for like a breath to feel that hip positioning that I'm in. I'm gonna go around the other side again. There's Pepper. I'm gonna take it back now to my starting point. We're gonna add on if you can. So from here, I'm going to extend and sit up. If you can't do that, that's okay. Just keep doing your shin box switches. I'm gonna lower down with control and flip around and do the other side. Sitting up. Feeling those front of the hips stretch there. Sitting down. Flipping around to the other side. Sitting up. Just do what you can. No worries, okay? Sitting down, switching around, and coming back up again. Awesome. Let's do one more each side. Extending, getting those hips and all their extended goodness. And coming back. Good. Yeah. All right. We're gonna change body positions again. This time, we're going to explore the world of half kneeling. So if you want a pad for under your knee, totally fine. So I have one knee down and one knee up. I'm gonna reach my arms up to the ceiling. Make sure you're tucking your bum under a little bit so you don't arch your low back. Tuck it under, reach. Then I'm gonna set them down and come back into that runner's lunge that I started in. So an option here would be to have some yoga blocks to elevate those hands. So I'm gonna stay right here, reach up, tucking the bum under. Placing my hands down and coming into that hip stretch again. Good. Set that knee back down. Back to half kneeling. We reach up. We reach down. Now you don't have to lift that back knee. You can get a stretch with it on the ground or you can lift it up. Let's go again. Half kneeling, reaching up, making sure we're tucking under a little bit. Reach down and lift that back knee off the ground. Good. So one more on this side, just reaching straight up towards the ceiling. Squeeze your butt cheek, set those hands down. And extend that, lift that back knee off the ground. Good, good. All right, now I'm gonna switch my half kneeling up so that I'm on the other side here. Little preset of my pelvic tilt. Gonna reach up. Reach down for the ground and lift. You can totally elevate those hands if you need to. Back to half kneeling, reaching up towards the ceiling, little pelvic tilt under, reach for the ground, and lift that back knee. Good. We got three more here. Reaching for the sky, little pelvic tilt, reach for the floor. And extend, lift that back knee up. Set it down, we're going again, reach high. Reach down. Runner's lunge. Good. We got one more here. Half kneeling, reach up. Reach for the floor and lift that back knee. Good, good. All right, we just have a few more drills. Like I said, 30 minute mobility goodness. So I'm gonna return to my half kneeling position here. We're gonna really hit the ankles this time from a different position. So I'm gonna take my front knee and swing it open. So half kneeling, open the gate. I'm gonna bring my heel a little closer to my butt. So keeping this heel on the ground and this knee in line with my toes, I'm gonna go forward and back. So make sure your heel stays glued to the ground. See how much my ankle is bending here? That's what we're going for. It's called ankle dorsiflexion. So we're getting it from a different angle than we did with our downward dog, which also works on ankle mobility. Good. Ankle mobility is so important to gait and knee health. And you ever hear those stories about someone driving into a storefront with their car? You know, that's ankle dorsiflexion. That's being able to put your foot on the gas or the brake and being able to move your ankle joint. So keeping that mobility so good. Get a little more on the side. Good. Now I'm gonna switch up. So this knee comes forward and then we swing open the gate, heel in line with knee. I'm just gonna bring that heel a little closer. Lock it to the, super glue it to the ground, and we're going on this side. Good. Just get whatever range of motion that you have, keeping that heel glued to the ground. Yeah, there goes Bartleby. You guys are doing great. There's been a lot of kind of different moves tonight. I'm gonna hit these again next week. Okay. So don't feel bad if you didn't get every single thing. That's okay, we keep practicing.
Okay.
We keep practicing. I've been doing these for years and I still have to get better at them. I'm gonna do one more little stretch to finish us off for the night. So we're gonna come back to quadruped. We're gonna do a cat, cow, and into a child's pose. All right, so we're just gonna go through that sequence about five times. Rounding up as far as you can. Tucking under as far as you can. And then you're gonna sit back as far as you can into child's pose. Hold that for a breath. And then we're gonna come back and do that about four more times. So we go round up. Tuck under. And then sit back. Round up, tuck under, and sit back. Good, we're gonna do two more of these. Cat cow. Rolling under. And sitting back. Last one, keep that breath flowing. Angry cat. Other direction. And sit back. Awesome. Awesome, awesome. So that is our 30 minute happy hour mobility. A lot to take in, I know, especially with that weird Bretzel one, but you guys did good. And I hope that you feel better. That's the most important thing.
Yes. Just
get that mobility going. So thanks everyone for coming. Feel free to shoot me with any questions in an email or text or whatever. And I hope I see you all soon. So have a good night.
Pepper was doing downward dog.
Yeah, I could see her. His tail going there.
There she is doing downward doggy.
With Yay! Mama.
Okay.
I see Bartleby in the background.
Yeah, he's cruising through.
He's a cutie. Aw, look at him.
He's a little bit of a camera whore, but... So is Pepper! Oh my goodness.
Oh yeah. She's totally... Yeah, she's into it. See you tomorrow, Robin.
All right.
Thank you so much, Robin.
Thank you. It's good to see all of you.
Thank you.
Have a good night.
You too. Bye.
Bye-bye.